your blonde bombshell here with you. I have got some dear bombshell questions. We're going to lead off with that, but first let's do the obvious. I went and had my hair done today. I have a new side bang thing going on. I'm trying to get used to this. It's the more mature me. And we're letting it grow out, but we had to eliminate some of the length, but it's actually still long. It's just curled. And it's beautiful, and it's falling because of the heat in the house. But enough about me. Let's get to these Dear Bombshell questions so we can move right on with the singing video that was a request. And then I'm going to go work out. So let's see here. Dear Bombshell, I'm trying to be creative. What can I get my love other than chocolate, stuffed animals, or flowers? If you want to be really creative, do something from the heart. Something that's homemade, whether it's an adult coloring book that has hearts in it that you sit down and you're like, you know what, I'm going to color you a picture and stick it inside a card that's homemade. You took time, which is the greatest gift that you can give somebody. It's not store-bought. It can't be returned. It's thoughtful. It shows you put your heart into it and you put your mind into it. To me, that's the best kind of gift. Of course, you can always go with necklaces, bracelets, or if it's for him, maybe hankies or something that he would use. My grandpa likes instant lottery tickets, so something like that. But again, it shouldn't be about what you buy. It should be about the thought that you put into it. What's a great song for Valentine's Day? Now this one, it ranges. You could be Baby I'm Amazed by You like Lone Star, to The Rose from Conway Twitty, to there's just so many great love songs. You really have to look, just do a YouTube search, because really it's based on what you think. But because some don't like country, some like rock. There's that Everything I Do It For You song by Bryan Adams, just for example. There's Chicago, not the city, the group, but just various things. Anyway. Should I surprise my Valentine? Well, if your Valentine is like me, I can't stand surprises because usually they don't work out. So I would say surprises are never good. What year was your best Valentine's Day and why? Well, if you were friends with me on Facebook, you know I already answered this. If you were friends with me on MeetMe, you know I already answered this, but I will answer it again. The best Valentine's Day for me was last year. And I had my grandma here with us. I had my dad, stepdad, Mike. But most importantly, I got to text my ex-boyfriend and we actually got to talk. Not physically, but, you know, it was nonverbal. And it was the best Valentine's Day ever just because of that. And when I got off doing that and I was telling my grandma who I was texting, her face lit up with joy and she was radiant and she was just like, I'm so happy, it's finally going to happen, and then won't go past what happened after that. But anyway, I would say that was the best year, and that would be why. It's ironic that my grandma went to the doctor on Valentine's Day last year, because I can remember coming out of the hospital, this little boy ran up to her and gave her a Valentine's Day balloon. It was so sweet and so cute. There's a picture on my Facebook of my grandma with that Valentine's Day balloon. It was so special. And also, I can, you know, my grandpa this year goes to the doctor on Valentine's Day, so put some prayers up there. Do I have plans myself? Other than going to the doctor and I understand my family's going out to lunch, no. And that's okay. I'm okay with that. So stay tuned. The singing request video is up next.